Meghan Markle and Prince Harry looked more blissful than ever as they kicked off their tour of South Africa, and according to one expert, there's a good reason why. According to a body language expert, the Duke of Sussex is still in his honeymoon phase with his wife Meghan. Body language expert Judy James told Fabulous Digital that Harry is still besotted with his wife, the Duchess of Sussex. The couple have only been married 1 year, but Harry still shows all the signs that he is still very firmly in love with his wife. As they began their tour of South Africa in Cape Town, Harry could be seen lovingly smoothing down his wife's ponytail and pulled her close as they met with school children with their four-month-old son Archie Harrison. Ms. James said, "It's pretty safe to evaluate, from their loving and affectionate body language, that the couple are still effectively on their honeymoon. If anything, their touches, and romantic, caring rituals, have become stronger, rather than showing any signs of cooling off." The body language expert pointed out a variety of adorable moments between the couple, which included Harry smoothing down the Duchess's hair just before a group photo was taken of them. Ms. James continued, "The subtle, thoughtful ponytail smoothing while Meghan was busy talking with her hosts is one of the strongest Thai sign rituals, with Harry communicating caring and affectionate attention to his wife even though his attention is diverted behind her. It's a reminder that he's around, but, with Meghan's confident and sociable approach in full swing, it's showing the love without any trace of a suggestion that he might think she's in need of support or encouragement." The body language expert also pointed out the couple's frequent hand-holding and touching of each other's backs, which is just another sign of their intimacy. She added, "Their hand-holding has been a constant eye sign for the couple, but here it's Harry who pulls the clasp behind his own torso to keep Meghan close and intensify the intimacy." Meghan's own quasi-parental backstroke gesture is another ritual that she's used throughout their marriage and one that she used the first time they showed baby Archie off in public. It suggests a mutual registering of love and support. Harry was also spotted finding something for his wife to sit on during their first engagement in Nyanga near Cape Town. She added, "He is in full gallant mode here, moving quickly and almost fussily to grab something for her to sit on as she prepares to get down on the floor. He seems to really enjoy this chance to be the Prince Charming, and as he sits back after smoothing it out, he claps his hands together merrily to show the act has made him as happy as it has her. He even looks across at Meghan for that eye connect signal of praise and approval before leaning back with a smile on his face." The couple kicked off their tour of South Africa yesterday wearing adorable matching bracelets. The couple were visiting the area of Nyanga to learn more about Justice Desk, which is a human rights organization supported by the Queen's Commonwealth Trust. Residents there took part in traditional dancing and wore costumes while live music was playing. The royal couple wore white and red beaded bracelets with the word justice spelt across the beads. The unique message was a nod to the charity they were visiting, which is called Justice Desk. The charity is supported by the Queen's Commonwealth Trust and has Prince Harry as its president and Meghan as its vice president. The charity's founder Jessica Dewhurst and community leader Theodora Lutuli hosted the couple's first royal visit of the day. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry were spotted sharing a romantic kiss before the Duke of Sussex left his wife to take on a solo engagement on their second day of the royal tour to Africa. Meghan and Prince Harry were spotted kissing near Mwambizi Beach, where they spent the morning learning about the Waves for Change Association and practicing meditation. The Duke of Sussex kissed his wife goodbye before leaving her to head to the dock to carry out a solo engagement. The kiss comes after the pair has been packing on the PDA during their first hours spent in South Africa. This morning alone, Harry sweetly stroked his wife's back more than once when they arrived at the beach to meet 25 mentors working with Waves for Change. Shortly after, Meghan and Harry walked hand in hand, a habit the Sussexes have been practicing since they became public. During their meeting with mentors of Waves for Change, the Cape Town-based charity helping teenagers in need, Meghan and Harry were also introduced to a meditation session. During the so-called power hand activity, the pair were invited to open up on what they believe their strengths are. Meghan said hers is parenting, which she and Harry are learning and developing. She then went on complimenting her husband, saying he is the best dad. Prince Harry reciprocated the compliment, and looking at Meghan in the eyes he said, "Ah, she is the best mom." And yesterday, Prince Harry was caught on camera stroking his wife's ponytail during a photo call in Cape Town. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex are known for being openly affectionate in public and tactile. The royal tour to Africa, which has been described by Prince Harry as fantastic during an interview where he said he was looking forward to introducing Cape Town to Meghan, has just started, but the royals have already carried out several engagements. After Meghan and Harry met with mentors at Waves for Change and kissed goodbye, the Duchess returned to the Sussex's residence in Cape Town, where her firstborn Archie Harrison Mountbatten Windsor is believed to be spending his days with his nanny. Harry, on the other hand, tried to tame the waves by sailing on a dinghy with members of the Cape Town's Marine Unit and Royal Marines. Speaking with some 30 members of the unit, Harry got to know more about the illegal poaching of abalones and how the organization is trying to stop it. The former soldier, who served twice in Afghanistan during his 10-year-long period in the army, also spoke to a couple of British Royal Marines, who showed the prince and members of the unit their tactics and surveillance skills. According to members of the unit, a plate of abalones can sell for as much as £430 in China. Following the return of Harry from his solo meeting with the Marine unit, the loved-up pair will visit together Bokap, a neighborhood built and leased to slaves in the 1760s. Meghan and Harry are also to visit South Africa's oldest mosque, Owo Mosque, and have tea with local residents. The day will close with a reception at the British High Commissioner's residence. The heartwarming moment Prince Harry stroked wife Meghan Markle's ponytail was caught on camera during a photo call in Cape Town today. Harry, 35, and Meghan, 38, arrived for day one of their 10-day tour of South Africa this morning, and kicked it off with a visit to Nyanga Township to meet with young people for the Thembakoto Club project. The club offers female empowerment workshops and self-defense classes to girls, and as they posed for a picture with the group, Harry was seen smoothing Meghan's ponytail into place. The royal couple are known for being openly affectionate in public, holding hands and being tactile with both each other and well-wishers, with historian David Starkey recently describing Meghan as a breath of fresh air to the royal family. The sweet move seen in the short video clip sees Meghan joining Harry among the group, before pulling a strand of hair which had fallen onto her shoulder, back into place. After smoothing her hair into place, Meghan turned to look back at Harry, before the besotted couple turned to face the couple. The PDA is not unusual for the young couple, who have shaken things up with their open approach to public engagements. During their tour of Australia, Fiji, Tonga and New Zealand last October, the couple were basking in the afterglow of their pregnancy announcement, and were frequently seen stealing affectionate glances, holding hands and touching each other's backs supportively. But despite the happy displays, Harry and Meghan have previously come under fire for being too affectionate in public, with some experts claiming it doesn't follow royal precedent and appears unprofessional. But the warm body language appears to have finally colored off onto other members of the family. Speaking to Mail Online previously from Mail, body language expert Judy James told how their warm displays appeared to be rubbing off on more formal William and Kate. She said, "Now that Meghan has joined the firm, her own determinedly tactile behavior with Harry does seem to have had a profound echo effect on William and Kate's rituals. Normally it's a younger sibling that will mimic or mirror the older, but in Harry and William's case it seems to be William taking his lead from his younger brother and his wife."